data were better, much more better than Moody's. But so the fact that the data are really available, friendly user, it's very important. And the problem, in my view, is not free of charge or not, and so on. It's the way you access the data. And that's very important to me. My second remark is a little bit different. Today, I think everybody in Europe and maybe quite in the world has seen the video data coming from satellite. Everybody in Europe has seen on the TV the météo data coming from the satellite, from Meteosat, okay. And so, when you ask for a budget to a government, all the people, all the ministers, they don't need to have paper and so on to understand that. They fully understand because they have seen the data. And I think it's also a problem for GNES. When we will be able to produce kind of data that will be very large diffusion for everybody. Everybody will have all this kind of data. I think the people will be, in their mind, more, let's say, keen to develop the GNES. But today, we don't have anything to reproduce, nothing, in fact. So it's also a way to consider, because the problem is not the budget. By the way, it's a small budget regarding overactivity. And just, maybe you have seen, Alain Ratier has delivered some days ago, the fact that we produce a top number, the number has 60 million
euros a year gain with
forecast. So it's
for Europe. For
Europe. So it's very, very interesting. I think GMES is the same order of magnitude. It's the same order of magnitude. So the budget versus the benefits, no discussion on that. But today we need to have, let's say, the people who have more the idea of what could be GMES, what could produce GMES, and so on. So we need to have data and to have open data to deliver data to the people. So I think it's a kind of last point, if I may. Dordain has been very good in explaining scientific part of Earth observation, operational part, and so on. The problem today, and what we are facing for the next ministerium, is that people have developed, we have developed some satellite in the next envelope program, in the past envelope program, and now we need to launch. And for a kind of, let's say, program à la carte, nobody wants to pay for the launcher. So it's a kind of, let's say, when you consider the problem of budget, we could not accept to develop satellites without the means, the operational means, the launcher, the exploitation, and so on. That needs to be put in the same budget. Otherwise, we face what we are facing today. Today, the risk is high that at the next ministerium, nobody wants to pay for the launcher. And that's crazy.
Mark, you have a long experience with Earth observation and the GMES at Astrium. How to ensure the continuity of these programs when the services they provide become fully operational?
Yes, thank you for the question. Some reaction as well with respect to what I've been told so far. First of all, I think that we should not be too much pessimistic as well. If we look at the situation where we were 1998. I was to be lucky as well to be in this Baveno story. I think that we've made a lot of progress in that time. Remember that one of the challenges French ones to try to trigger the interest of user communities with respect to services based on Earth observation. And frankly speaking, I think that on that we were not a bad one, because we have now new users. Let's take the example of civil security people, for example, who are now completely, we have now completely integrated the fact that Earth observation is a tool which can be operationally used for their tasks, for their missions. And I think that now there is no doubt to consider that GMS services for emergency support can be and are operational services. We are not talking anymore about R&D, about research of that. It's really a matter of operational services, operational use of Earth observation for a community of users who were not using at all Earth observation 15 years ago. Same example for land cover or water management as well. We have now water agencies in some regions using GMES services and Earth observation data for their daily operation. And that's new, by the way. Something which is coming out from some development made in the past decade thanks to GMS program. So I think that we should not be also too much pessimistic with respect to the achievement made in these last decade. Now the question is how to go forward for the future. First point, I think that we should not forget the users, because at the end it's something which is which was at the root of the GMS story, and we should not forget this root. And among the users, I would say that personally I consider that there is one community which is not enough represented in the GMS panorama, which are the European regions. Because most of the services addressed by GMS are indeed under the competences of the regions, European regions. And they have a word to say, specifically in terms of the sustainability of the services, because if they want, and I think they want, to use the GMS services in their mission of managing the land at the regional level, I think that they should be convinced as well that there is a kind of sustainability in terms of services which is possible only if they can pay their operations. So first point, don't forget the user. I think that the user should also be involved in the way to build up the economic model. A second point which I think is important is that we should not confuse between GMS data and Sentinel data, because as Jean-Paul said, GMS services are using several kinds of data. Some are coming from Sentinel satellites, some are coming from other satellites, some are coming from something else than satellites. So we cannot have a GMS data policy as such. Depends on the data sources. And the second point that I stopped here, should also avoid to make the confusion between data and information or services. Because at the end, what is important, and I think it is still the objective of GMS, is not to deliver data, but real operational services and information.